This must be the saddle bump that didn't run off our deer.
Might well be.
You do that? You run off our deer?
Only deer's been through here past that way. About an hour ago, I reckon.
You calling me a damn liar?
Ain't one to judge a man before I've had a chance to meet him. Wade McCurry.
Archie Ainsworth.
He ain't apologized for the deer.
That there's my brother Ben. We're out of Georgia. Where do you hail from, Wade?
Cheyenne.
And for that?
Texas, originally.
Pleasure's all mine.
And you reckon your brother might lower his sidearm?
You ain't gonna shoot a fellow Southerner, are you, Ben?
Hoods Texans! You know, at the side of them, them damn Yanks just throw down their guns, run like the wind. You should have seen them at Chickamauga. Yellow-bellied cowards, the whole damn lot.
Running don't make a man a coward.
Who'd you serve under?
Was it Hood?
What are y'all boys doing now?
We're heading west. I heard there's a strike.
Shut your trap.
I ain't got no interest in mining.
That's like saying you ain't got no interest in making it rich.
Can't rightly say I do. Fact is, I'm trying my hand at farming.
Farming? I don't look like no farmer either, Saul.
That's on account of being Deputy Cheyenne the last 2 years.
Well, Deputy, you ain't said who you served under.
I fought.
Hold it there, Ben.
Keeping company with the deserter.
I fought.
Under Taylor, then?
Not under Taylor.
Not under Smith.
Hector? Or Hood, neither. I served under the command of General Thomas.
Don't know no General Thomas.
Thought you boys said you were at Chickamauga.
Yankee traitor.
Don't. I gotta go for it, Judge.
Promise me, next time a self-respecting Southerner asks you who you served under...
I ain't no traitor.
Next time you ought to lie.
Ain't no liar, neither.
Yeah, just because you made peace with your past, don't mean the world has.
World, I damn well cooled off already. I gotta go for a judge or not.
Nah. Seems like a fair fight to me. I'll just have Stovetop Charlie bring his Chinaman over. Yep. You're going to be pig food. Yes, you are, you secesh dirt. Wade, seeing as how you ain't been around lately. By the by, way May Todd's been talking, sounds though she's aiming to make a respectable man out of you.
Thank you kindly if you dispose of that for me.
Joe McCurry, your paw.
I reckon that depends on which one of us you're asking.
Don't you think you ought to read the thing?
Ain't as though he read any of mine.
That's your family.
No. That's the man said he'd shoot me if I ever came back to him.
This is why we have horses in the first place.
Can't ride them all day.
Just give me a gosh darn minute.
Shit. Starting to have second thoughts where you're gonna be all right without me.
Hell, Wade, you were my deputy. It ain't like we're kin. I ain't your responsibility.
I told you quit about damn letter.
My boy's hiding down in Mexico on account of a killing over a girl. That's a hanging offense. And yet a day don't go by where me and Janie don't think on him. Because that's the thing about blood, Wade. Ain't nothing in this world can truly break it.
Come on.
He really threatened to shoot you?
Ain't home now, am I?
Well, did it ever occur to you that he just might have changed his mind?
All we know is this world around us and the people who inhabit it. We trust your grace and love to...
This ain't no sermon, ain't.
Fine sermon, Reverend. Sure is. Ain't for his ears, though. There ain't no kind words ever escaped your father's lips about that fella.
We are here to remember the dead, not dishonor them by brawling on their grave.
Well, this here greedy carpet-bagging son of a bitch is a-doing your family the damn dishonor. Now, you know, I would never do Joe no disrespect, but it ain't right.
Be fine if you come stand by Hick and me. Paul would have wanted it that way, I think.
You mean that?
He lost you at cards more times than he could count. Still, he kept on coming back.
Well, you think you and Heck might maybe want to come and visit a lonely old man one of these days?
You sing with me?
Shall we gather at the river where broad angel feet have trod, with its crystal tide forever flowing by the throne of God?
Mr. Lang.
My apologies for the trouble my presence has caused.
As far as meetings with Threepenny Hank go, I'd say yours wasn't all that bad.
Best not begrudge a man in mourning. He and your father are very close.
Well, ain't nobody else could stand either of them. Well, my thanks to you for allowing me to be in attendance. You come to understand a man sitting across a negotiating table. And your father was as fine as he was hard-headed.
Well, perhaps one day soon, you will get to know us that well.
Is that a fact?
Not my father, Mr. Lane.
Well, you certainly are not. I do imagine you have an asking price.
Mr. Lane, may I pay respects to my father. Business will be conducted at the proper time. We appreciate your support in this hard moment.
The lady said her goodbyes.
Well, you let her know I'll be back in a month's time with a bill of sale.
Well, I do think Martha aims to be done with this place my bit sooner than that.
Tell me, Mr. Kirkland, you ever traveled to Lawrence, Kansas?
May have ridden through.
Well, here it used to be beautiful. Especially by firelight. Be a pleasure doing business with you.
That mule got the loco weed again. Had to put it down.
Needed to be done. Lane ain't by today.
He'll come. A few weeks is what he said. You ought to eat.
I like how much you like my food.
Got enough.
You thought on the food we'll have in San Francisco?
Well, I heard good night took another herd up to Kansas.
It could be.
Cows aren't no better than crops. We're opening a hotel.
I ain't exactly the hotel type.
You weren't exactly the farming type either. It'll be a grand place. Grandest in San Francisco. With large green drapes, a polished wood entrance, children running all through. Lane's coming.
That ain't Lane.
Do we have to?
Stay in the house.
This McCurry place?
Who's asking?
I ain't angling for a fight.
Folks don't ride out this way unless they're angling for something.
Be obliged if I could water my horses. Been riding hard these last days. Wrong way. I got business with the McCurrys.
Ain't you hurt? Joe McCurry's dead.
I heard. Mary about James and Billy.
Dead too.
Dead? No, they ain't.
See for yourself. Stranger?
All of them?
If any want to water your horses, be on your way. It's fine by me. Stay inside. I'll be gone soon.
Ask him how he knows it, Billy.
Thank you kindly. I was wondering if a... Martha? How'd you do so much growing? It's Wade. Your brother.
Right on out of here right now, mister.
It's been a while, I know. But it's me. Sure as a gun.
Wade is dead. He's killed by a horse 10 years past on his way to war.
You still got that scar from the fever? One right inside your arm? The trip was supposed to take 4 days, but I had to ride 6 straight on account of the weather. If I hadn't been delayed, they would have never tried to bleed you.
Wade?
I ain't dead, little sunshine.
And then Wade here comes bursting through, half his face white with cream, other smooth as a baby's bottom, and me, I'm standing there covered in mud and dirt, sobbing like the little girl I was. It must have taken you a good hour to wipe all that dirt off of me.
Not the last time you saw each other?
I'm looking at her now.
Well, that night Wade left for the war.
Youngins?
This ain't no place to raise a child.
Sure is a fine piece of land, though.
Fine with fresh eyes, I'd imagine.
And how come it is this is the first year you're seeing it?
Heck.
It's a fair question.
What's that?
It's a letter.
Would you ever imagine your baby sister be reading and writing? This is from Paul. Wade, it is with much worry that I seek myself to pen you. How'd this get so burnt?
It's legible.
Things do not stand well between us. I make no apologies, and I write you now only because I see nowhere else. You are always the responsible one, and I beseech you now to be responsible for the family. When'd you get this?
2 weeks passed.
Joe's been in the ground a month.
Yeah.
We've been living for these past years on a homestead, and I beseech you, watch over the family, for if you are reading these words, then I am killed.
What are you aiming to do here, mister?
Said it.
I reckoned you did.
Are you taking leave of me?
Wasn't my intent to cause you pain. How'd he die?
Just thrown by a horse.
Something bothering you? You can tell me.
It's strange is all. Seeing as how we thought you did.
Why you reckon Joe wrote me that letter?
I think I'd rather know what it is you're wanting.
I'd prefer not to sleep in Joe's room. If that's all right with you.
I do believe we could do something about that.
He should be gone.
Speak on it in the morning.
We'll speak on it now.
We will do no such thing, Heck Kirkland. You were tight.
We'll say nothing on it till you've regained your moral character.
Mr. Bunny Hank sent that letter sure as spit.
Don't I know it?
Wayne will kill you. He finds out what you've done.
It's my brother.
Joe was your father.
He's in a better place now.
Wade raised me. No pa ever did.
I'd have run him off.
What if I don't want that?
Put it to him? There ain't nothing that keeps a man away for coming on 10 years.
Of course there's a reason.
Maybe you ought to find out what it is. Maybe while you're thinking on it, you gotta ask yourself, why'd a father declare his son dead?
Where's your mat?
Martha believes I'll make a better husband without it.
Best not argue then.
Pinfire, ain't it?
Federal I took it off of claimed he got it from Jeb Stewart himself.
I reckon he didn't part with it easily.
No man would.
Good talk.
Where you been these last years?
I ain't one for repeating myself.
Being a deputy in Cheyenne.
I'm a farmer now.
That still don't explain why you ain't never come through.
Maybe you ought to ask Joe. But I guess you missed your opportunity for that.
You do anything that's gonna hurt her, there won't be no conversation next time.
Stole the words right out of my mouth.
Face your responsibility.
Got that talking to as well?
Stay, I don't know if we deserved it or if Ma just plain enjoy giving it.
I don't mean to be out of line, but isn't this a husband's responsibility?
Look at where we live. More chores and people around here.
How'd you two start courting?
I wouldn't exactly call it courting. Hector ended up looking for work at Three Penny Hank's place. He found his way over here.
Three Penny Hank?
Just a fool whoremonger. Heck's a good man. He would never do me no harm.
A man who carries a gun like that, he has a certain kind of past.
me with something?
Who'd you bury in my stead?
Nobody. Like I could use this wake. Wade is alive and well. Guessing you probably knew that, seeing as he's not up there with you, but right now he's standing right here next to me. He's been living up in the Wyoming Territory, where he used to be a deputy sheriff. He's not married yet, but not for lack of interest in women, I'm sure. And I'm hoping that he was staying here with me and Heck for a spell. If there's anything you'd like to say.
Howdy. Would have been nice to see y'all. Alive, I mean.
Bodies back from the war. Not for you. Not for Jamie. Not for Billy.
Ma is actually buried here. As Pa.
Of course.
How'd she pass?
She got weak after the war. Doc said he didn't know why, but it was on account of losing her boys. Sure as the day is long. Pa, he moved us out here thinking maybe a fresh start might help. But
again, this place, it killed her slowly. James signed on soon after Pa told us you died. All boys in town did. Whole town was so proud, mightily so. Then came Sharpsburg. None came back. Not a one. And more left. This time Billy signed on. He lost a leg at Chickamauga. Billy died of infection on his journey home. There's something wrong with the way they healed his leg. Every boy between the age of 13 and 34 out of old Grand Ridge, Texas, gave their life fighting them damn Federals. Except you.
I fought.
Not with the First Texas.
I was injured early on. When I was fit for duty, I was reorganized into a convalescent regiment.
Was it bad?
I ended up in a hospital, if you want to call it that. I was lucky to survive. That's a fact. Let the past lie, little sunshine. This is the here and now.
Thank you.
What's he done to make you trust
him? Still hanging on to that damn letter, for one.
That damn letter brought way home to me. Why don't you just focus on killing us an elk? A couple of pheasants just won't do.
Look, family don't turn against each other without reason.
Time was Paul took the selling faulty tools to passing miners. Wasn't too much of a surprise when one party came back looking for a refund. I thought he'd have none of it, but Wade, you getting their money back? All of it? He did so knowing full well the beating he'd be taking for it. Same reason to turn against Paul, ain't too hard to find. Asking Wade to come with us to San Francisco.
Yeah.
Heard you were going hunting. Thought you could use a repeater. You couldn't hit a buck with that antique.
Damn Yankee rifle? 16 shooter?
Mighty sweet of you.
That three pin, how you feel? You reckon he's the one that sent Joe's letter?
The hell kind of cartridge is this?
44 rim fire.
I can't say I thought on it much.
Now his place, I saw a few miles west of here.
Three pin Hank's been living by himself on a dying farm for more years than I can count. Makes a man a little crazy.
I've been thinking on something. Plow that land out there, plant it right, mm-hmm. This farm could really be something.
You don't think Joe tried that?
It's a fine piece of land y'all got here.
We're selling the farm.
What if it's help you need, I could stay on the stretch, bear some of the burden. Well, I mean, it's a shame. The
decision's been made.
You sure, little sunshine?
Decision's made.
Penny Hank?
I don't take kindly to that name, mister. Give it here. I ain't a young man no more. Well, Sergeant Major McCurry, I swan. Wasn't sure there was going to be a body on the other end of this. It's a pleasure to make your acquaintance, Sergeant Major. A real pleasure.
It's Wade.
You ain't trying to pull one on me now, are you?
Joe didn't say nothing.
Hell no, he did not. I can see it, though. You got your father's eyes. Well, come on in. It's hot as a whorehouse on nickel night. We can deal a few hands, see if you got your father's luck, too.
Joe. He ain't wanting to change his mind.
One hand. I ain't had a visitor since your pa was killed.
Well, I reckon you better take that up with his horse.
Hold on just one minute. I ain't no soaker, but we respect the dead before we speak on them. Here's to you, Joe. Turns out I was right. You were a lying son of a bitch. You will be missed.
Joe.
You mustn't think much of me.
Can't say I've made much of an opinion.
No. But I know a lot of folks who don't. Crazy old coot. Couldn't grow mushrooms on manure. But I'm a hell of a good farmer. Just ain't much water. Not around these parts, anyway.
The letter.
Hold your horses, son. We're talking water here.
My family's dead. It's the only place that has it.
I can see you are the observant kind. What ain't so obvious is that there's copper plenty around here. And if the mining companies...
come here.
If the mining companies ain't got no water to work their claims, well, then that ore ain't ever seen the light of day. They need Joe's land. And they sent some good-for-nothing carpetbagger named Elaine to make sure they get it.
Just because a man's under fire doesn't mean he can't be snake bit.
If it was an accident, how come the coffin was closed?
It's an awful big charge you're making.
Well, he weren't scalped by no Apache. He was throwed by a horse. Ain't no reason not to let us say our last respects unless... unless he weren't throwed by no horse.
And the law? They ain't had nothing to say about this?
There ain't no law around here. You know, Joe never said more than two words about you. But I wager I can guess why he told folks that you was dead, Sergeant Major. Hell, he must have been in it bad if he felt you were the one that he had to call out to. Because like you said, Joe ain't one to change his mind.
Were you present when Joe died?
So you've been by Three Pancakes Place?
You don't take too kindly that name.
Nobody take too kindly to him either.
You mentioned a fellow by the name of Lane. Came to Joe's funeral?
Mr. Lane's the buyer.
You killed Joe?
Nobody killed him. He was thrown by a horse.
Ain't that what killed me?
So you're saying I'm a liar?
This Lane, did he threaten you?
I don't want this land, Wade. The only reason we stayed so long is Pa wouldn't have survived out here on his own.
Hank seems to be doing just fine.
This place, it will kill me. Sure as it did our ma.
Joe threatened if I ever came home, he'd kill me. And there he goes. Writing me a letter, asking me back. That sound like the pride-stricken man that raised us up?
Nobody killed him.
I reckon I don't know how you can be so sure.
Asking you as your only family, will you please leave it alone?
Ain't no reason to be scared, little sunshine. I will strike down anyone who tries to run this here family.
Howdy. Didn't know Heck brought on any hands.
Howdy. Don't be bothering to dismount.
I did not believe we had the pleasure of an acquaintance.
You're E.J. Lane. Banker and killer.
I'm gonna bring you for a judge for what you've done.
Wait! You let him go! There ain't a judge for a 3-day ride from here!
It's quite the impertinent way to treat a guest.
I do apologize, Mr. Lane.
I think
we had
a move. I'd appreciate it if you get my horse.
She ain't to be ordered about. Wade, is it?
I'd be glad to know what I'm being accused of.
Didn't figure you on for games.
Wade.
Well, you know that a crime, whatever it may be, requires evidence. So please, present yours. Moving, yet meaningless. I'm sorry for your loss. I've been known for trying to put reason to accident in my time. I have a sale to attend to. So you can either shoot me in the back, like a coward, or let me be on my way.
You know, I ain't got no choice.
See, you've made an offer for this glass. But this glass is full of whiskey. And what you're trying to do is buy this glass and get the whiskey for free.
Why don't you take that whiskey, pour it right back in that bottle?
I'm making a fair counter here. It is $1,000. The $750 for all my acres, $250 for everything on it.
It's your property. Imagine you'd want to say in its fate.
Hell and imagination.
We got a deal?
On behalf of Mr. Moore, Mr. Cronin, Mr. Buck.
Thank you kindly.
Thank you.
I was invited here on business. You just hold on a minute here.
I'm gonna see you home.
Innocent men have nothing to fear from the law.
Where's the nearest judge? No reason to fear, little sunshine. He ain't gonna hurt you.
It's Judge Hawkins. In Alameda. Three-day ride from here.
Get up.
I know the way.
Hold it.
I'm going to drop on.
No, I will talk to you.
The only thing he's going to listen to is a bullet.
He will listen to me.
And what has he done to make you think a crazy notion like that?
I can't.
God damn it, Martha. He dug up your father.
You stop right there, Wade McCurry.
I'll sound. The faster we get done with this nonsense, the better.
You best not try anything.
I have been trying to leave this place for going on 4 years now. First, Ma got sick, then Pa needed me to stay, and now you.
You're asking I let him go.
I'm asking you to let me be rid of this place for good.
What world you want to go out into? Wouldn't be a place fit living. Not without the law.
Farm, Wade. You and me and Heck will go to San Francisco as a family.
I was hoping on coming back this way, if you'll have me.
You do this, you're betraying the only kin you got left.
You sound like Pop.
I am nothing like him. Why'd he tell us you were dead?
This ain't about the past.
No, it isn't.
He tried to stop me from leaving just like you're doing now. The words he said to me aren't words you forget. Right out here. You ain't my son. You're a goddamn traitor. And if our boys don't kill you, I will.
Where are you going?
I reckon you know.
No, I need to hear you say the word.
I was going to join the Union Army to fight for my country.
We're your Sharpsburg.
No.
Chickamauga. What about Chickamauga?
Thank you.
drive for 3 days without any sleep.
I ain't telling you not to.
I'll fall off.
And you'll pick yourself right back up again.
Oh. I didn't kill your father.
That's for a judge to decide.
Yeah?
You know you're on old man Race's land.
Suppose he was the one doing the shooting at me.
You're real lucky I was coming after you.
That's so. Yep.
That your blood?
Don't see no one else around.
Well, you best get up on out of there so we can see you bandaged up.
That'd be 16.
Didn't figure you one for a coward.
Ain't got no water, and you are bleeding something fierce. It's a mighty hard way to go. But figure that's about what to do, a damn Yankee. Thanks for this here repeater. It's a mite step finer than that infield.
You must have had a hell of a time bushwhacking Joe with that old thing.
Can't say I'd rather know. Martha is one hell of a shot, though.
Thank you.
had to be done. Was it quick?
There ain't no such thing. At least not for a goddamn Yankee traitor.
Nobody ought to have to die slow. Mr. Lane, I do apologize for what you've been through. It's been hard for all of us, but...
problem. $900 then. On account of your troubles.
You listen here. We still want to sell this place, and you still want to buy it. So you best make up your mind, because we don't got all day. $100 in there.
It's 200, actually.
My husband saved your life.
From what? A 3-day ride? A visit with Judge Hawkins? Do we have an agreement? Bullshit, we do. $200 is more than enough to get you to, where was it? San Francisco, I believe.
And do what once we get there?
That, my dear, is up to you. I'm a businessman. Not a fool. Now that ain't no way to treat your host. Isn't that right, Martha? time to break most men.
Well, what if it don't? I mean, he's stubborn.
Joe was stubborn, too.
I told you no.
That's the thing about killing. You open that door, I ain't telling how many gonna go through.
I won't last the winter here. Not with what we got. That lane, we got nothing.
Just stay out here. Uncivilized.
Martha keeps a clean house.
You're gonna be keeping it a lot longer if you kill me.
Nah. What was it you said? $200 more than enough to get to San Francisco.
I could have gone to the law.
You honestly trying to threaten me?
Negotiate, actually. I think maybe you don't know the difference.
Heck! We talked on this!
Yeah. You best stand clear.
He is a man of business. He did not ride out all this way to leave empty-handed.
I'll let you know about your husband here. You know, he rode with William Quantrell. Bloody Bill Anderson. He burnt Lawrence, Kansas to the ground. Killing women and children. And when there was no war to satisfy his lust for violence, he took up with Archie Clinton. Killed a deputy in Missouri. Before he escaped west. I know who I do business with, Miss Kirkland.
And I know who I married, Mr. Lane. Hick ain't that man no more.
Isn't he? $900 in. I think that'd be acceptable to me.
All right, then. Let's go back to the house and make it official. Take your hands off of me!
Ain't no time to get all worked up.
No time. He agrees with the deal. You had no call to shoot
him. If I hadn't have shot him, he'd have gone straight to the law.
You had a deal?
There's always a better deal.
$200 is no deal at all. What about the law folks? You're gonna notice Lane's gone missing.
Don't be too busy hunting Apache.
What's the matter, boy? Heavy? Martha! Martha! Open up now, you hear?
Give me crowbait if that's all you got.
I'll lend you my best mare once you're strong enough to ride her.
Don't make me no horse thief.
You figure Heck killed Joe?
Sure as hell shot me.
I'll get my double barrel.
Damn it, Hank! I don't want you with me.
Joe was my friend.
He's my paw.
Yeah? And which one of us you reckon knew him better?
Martha. She's the one that's supposed to have done it.
Hell, they was always fighting, but still, what you gonna do?
That's a family matter.
Time for you to ride on out of here.
Well, you.
You stood before Lord and family and you made me a promise.
You're pretty as a hummingbird. Still are.
Don't you start with me, Kirkland. You scalped a man.
Well, thing about getting hitched. You learn about each other. And you do things for each other.
Is that
Lane's?
How much?
I ain't rightly counted yet. A lot.
Should have negotiated better.
I figure that is more than enough to get us that hotel in San Francisco.
Who are you at Kirkland?
I'm the man. It's getting you your dream.
Leave them. We'll buy new china. Nicer ones, too.
Nicer means there won't be no memories.
Yeah, well, Apache wouldn't want no cups. Sure would like these furs, though.
Don't plan on living like a savage.
Well, we best leave like one if we don't want no posse coming after us.
stay in the house!
Did you do it? Did you kill Paul?
I don't know what you did to us. He left. My whole family died because of it. You killed my husband. You killed your little brother. Paul would never have brought us to this awful place if it weren't for you!
And you killed him for it.
I did what needed to be done.
Need to go before a judge. Martha.
You stand clear.
You know I can't.
All you got to do is put one foot in front of the other. Don't, that's too much to ask, my only kin.
This thing,
It's for the law to decide.
What law? I don't see none around here.
The world don't work that way, little sunshine. We gotta face our responsibility.
You were more of a father to me than Pa ever was.
There ain't no running from what we've done.
We'll draw then.
Pull that trigger. You're gonna have to shoot me straight.
Draw, goddammit!
I should never left you.